What we are discussing, DRS. Yesterday we have tested how DRS functions in fully automated, partially automated, and manual automated way in two situations: whenever you power on or every 5 minutes, right? How it will behave when you select multiple options, that we tested yesterday. And also I gave you one scenario. Scenario is, provide this is the problem statement. Means failover cluster means you will have a two machines. Let me take host one. Two host three, right? So I said I have a few virtual machine. One virtual machine is Windows one, that is primary, and some Linux and some other Windows servers. Okay, there is another Windows server. So on like that, you have multiple VMs on multiple hosts. What I did, I took this virtual machine and I took this virtual machine and I have configured configured failover cluster. Understood? Means Windows clustering. You know how it works? I hope I don't need to explain. And if one goes down, at least the secondary server will help to run the application without any downtime. Without any downtime means there is no downtime in it. Now the problem statement is, you know what HA will do? You know what HA will do? I have a cluster, VMware cluster. Now you will enable HA and DRS both on top of cluster. Agree? You'll enable both on the cluster. Now what HA will do if this host goes down? It will restart all the VMs on other host or other remaining host. What DRS will do? DRS will always check, fully automated DRS I'm talking about, will always check, and if there is any discrepancy in the resource utilization and the performance and stuff, so it will calculate, and just to load balance the resources across the cluster, it will migrate VMs from one host to another host. Okay, now this is primary VM1 and this is secondary VM in the same failover cluster. Okay, you created this VM on host one and the secondary VM on host two and configure the cluster. What happened when the DRS is calculating the load balancing parameters, or DRS is calculating the CPU and memory thresholds across the host? It found that this host is overutilized. This host is overutilized. Then what it will do? It will pick up one of the machine as per their calculation. System-defined algorithm. We don't really say you just move these, or you just move these, or you just move this. We will not even control it. Okay? System will automatically pick and migrate one of the VM from this host number two to other host. So it will migrate our vMotion to this host, and the VM is running here. Possible or not? Condition. Situation can happen, right?
Yes.
In this case, what is the potential? What is the potential? What we call it as? What is the potential harm that can happen to the customer environment? I can say there may be a chance that if this host goes down, your primary and your secondary both will dead. Okay, then what HA will do? HA will come and pick both the VMs and restart it after 5 minutes. It's okay, after 5 minutes both the VMs will up and running, but customer is paying for two servers just to avoid that 5 minutes downtime. He don't want to face that 5 minutes downtime. Even for that reason only he asks for two servers, otherwise there is no point of using two servers. You getting my point?
Yes.
Okay, how to avoid this situation means whenever system is calculating, when the system is calculating DRS rules and stuff, if it is trying to load balance some of the servers here and there, we should say, DRS, please listen to my words. What is your words? Simple. Never keep Windows, VM1 and Windows VM2 on same host. This is the statement. You getting what I'm trying to explain? Please don't keep these two servers at the same place. Okay. Imagine your childhood days. You and your friend sitting on the same bench and making a lot of noise. What they will do? One will be thrown into that corner, another will be thrown into this corner. Still you people start laughing. Still you people laugh. Okay. Similarly, you can set some rules, right? Simple rule saying, never keep these two machines in single host. Okay. This rule, technically you call it as Scroll down. Affinity, anti-affinity rules. You call it as In order to set up affinity and anti-affinity rules, follow the steps. Okay, he's not explaining the anti-affinity rules. Anti-affinity means separate virtual machine. Affinity means keep virtual machines together. Okay, fine. Okay, so what I will do, I'll have to define this anti-affinity rule to enable this functionality. Clear on this? Never keep Windows VM1 and Windows VM2 on same host. That is possible with anti-affinity rule. Anti-affinity means never ever keep machines in a same host, or always separate these two machines. Clear on this? If I apply anti-affinity rule on VM1 and VM2, they will never ever keep they never ever move it to same host when the DRS is running. When the DRS is executing something in the background logic, it will first read the rules. Okay, I should follow these rules, then I should take a decision. Based on that, it will calculate the DRS and it will move some other VM. If this host is overutilized, instead of moving this VM, it will move this VM to here. Understood? So that load will be balanced. Clear? How to do that? Let's test it very quickly. Anti-affinity rule. How how to set the rule and how to execute it. Let's see. I have a cluster, and if you look at machines, three machines are running on one host. 2, 3, 6, 1, 8, 5, 4, 7, 9. This is how the current state of configuration is. Now I want to set some rule. Pick any two VMs. I will treat them as a cluster. It's up to you. Pick any two VMs. 2 and 3. 2 and 3. Primary, secondary. Possible? Nice. Okay. We'll pick VM2 as a primary, VM3 as a secondary. Okay. These two VMs currently running on same host. Once if I apply the rule and run the DRS once, the rule will be executed automatically. One of the VM will go away from this host. One of the VM will go away from this host because the rule is never keep these two VMs on a single host. So currently they are running on single host without any additional manual configuration or without any manual movement. System should move 2 or 3, any one VM from host number 1 to 2 or 3, somewhere else. Clear? How to do that? Let's see. Go to cluster, configure. DRS is already enabled. No need to write any rules over here. And edit, I will set it to fully automated DRS. And now if you look at configuration, scroll down a little bit, VM host rules. Okay, VM host rules, add Windows failover Windows cluster rule 1. Right, Windows cluster rule 1. Separate virtual machines. Okay, add 2 and 3. That's it. Okay, rule is enabled. Now you look at monitor DRS recommendations. You can wait for 5 minutes, or you can simply execute the DRS once. Okay, I have executed the DRS. Now wait for some time. Machine 2 or machine 3, it should go away. See, machine 2 is migrating. Done. Now you look at minimize VMs. Machine 2 came to host number 2, and machine 3 is running on host number 3. If you want, you can manually this VM migrate it onto 1. Right? Migrate it onto 1. Now again, it is back to same host. I have manually relocated. Now, if I go back, monitor and run DRS, it should again migrate to somewhere else. See, again it's migrated. This time it is migrated to host number 3. You get what I'm trying to explain here? Got it?
Yes.
And any other rules that we can think of it? Let me think of a few scenarios. Okay. If there is a requirement, machine 1 and machine 2 and machine 3, and so on. Few machines are there. Okay. Now, there is a I cannot recollect exact scenario on which situation he will use this, but let me give you simple scenario. If machine 1 and machine 2 has a requirement saying they should always run on a single host. You understood? The requirement is these two virtual machine must be running on single host. If the DRS is trying to migrate one VM, it should migrate two VMs together. It should not migrate one VM. You getting my point?
Yes.
Okay. On which situation this kind of rule will be used? I mean, I didn't remember exactly. I cannot recollect it for which customer we have implemented this. But yeah, the rule is in such a way. Okay, virtual machine 1 and virtual machine 2 are having some interlink. Okay, and if the application should function perfectly, these two machines must be on the same host. If there is any such requirements, in that condition you can write these kind of rules. Okay, for this, what you what is the rule that you'll write? VMs I'm sorry, just a moment. Keep VMs together. Keep virtual machines together. Affinity. The rule name is affinity. Okay. What do you call it as? Affinity rule. Now, let's go to vCenter. Let's go to vCenter and try to find some VM. Okay, now let's decide VM1 and VM9. VM1 and VM9, they must be together. That's a logic. So how to define? Very simple. Go to configure, rules, add role, affinity underscore role 1. Keep virtual machines together. Now 1 and 9, they must be together. Okay, now they are currently running on, 1 is running on host 1, 9 is running on host 3. Okay, now we go to monitor DRS recommendations, run DRS. You should see 9 will go away. 9 will move on to host 1. VM9. See? Because VM9 is sitting on host 3. When I checked it, VM9 is sitting on host 3. Host 3 has 4 VMs, and host 1 has only 2 VMs. So what happens? Yeah, 1 and 9. Now both are running on host 2. Now can I create one more rule saying VM2 and VM3 must be on the same host? What is VM2 and VM3? In my previous example, they are failover host cluster. Sorry, failover cluster machines. Okay, I have created one rule saying please never ever keep these two machines together. That is the first rule. Now I am saying, can I write a one more rule saying 2 and 3 must be on a same host? Okay, let me see if that works or not. Go to virtual machines role. Affinity role. keep virtual machine together. Okay, 3 and 2. Okay, when I click OK, you must get an error. See, this rule is in conflict with the existing rules in the cluster. It will be disabled. Rule can be enabled manually when the conflicts are resolved. It is conflicting with rule one. Rule one is the Windows failover cluster rule. What you have mentioned over there, you mentioned separate virtual machines. Now you are trying to write one more rule. Keep virtual machines together. Okay, the system will confuse, right? Which statement it should pick, whether it should separate or it should keep together, which one it should pick, it's confused. So what it is saying, the first rule is active, the second rule which you are trying to create, it is now in disabled state, you will not be able to use it. Okay, if you want to use this, please disable the first one, then enable this one, then only it will work. You understood? Cancel. So rule is not even created. You getting what these rules are?
Yes.
Okay. Now one more scenario. What scenario name is VM to host mapping. Now take a cluster. How many hosts that you can keep it in cluster? How many hosts that you can keep?
64,
right? Okay. And so on, 64. How many VMs that you can run? Any idea? How many VMs that you can run?
Per host 254.
It's 1024 is the limit. 1024 is the limit per host. It's okay. Imagine around 1,000 machines are running. Just an example. Out of all the 64 hosts, you can see 1,000 or 1,500 machines are running. Agree? So out of these 1,000 machines, around 950 machines belongs to customer production. 950 machines belongs to customer production, and rest of the 50 VMs belongs to management purpose. What do you mean by management purpose? Hello, guys, come on quickly. What do you mean by management purpose?
Like user management.
Management purpose means if your company want to run the business, these 50 VMs are the backbone VMs in the backend, like your Active Directory, your DNS, your DHCP, your file, your print, your antivirus, and your security and patching, SCCM, Blade Logic, and so on. If you combine all those servers, all those functionalities, file and print servers. Right, if you combine all of them, you call it as management service. In the sense customer is not bothered about all those machines. If their machines are down, it's okay, he will not complain because his business is running on other 950 machines. These 50 machines are backbone to run those 950 machines in the front. Okay, if you have a 950 machines, I'm saying, out of which 800 machine are Windows machines. All the Windows servers, you must join into domain, right? Okay, where the domain is sitting, the domain is configured on few of these servers. Means out of these 50 servers, 5 or 6 domain controllers are there. You getting my point? Okay, now you want to access your servers, customer want to access his servers, or you want to access your servers with the name, not with the IP, then what you will do? DNS server. So out of these 50, 2 or 4 DNS servers also there. Agree? Now you have around you have around 10 different VLANs. 10 different VLANs. Okay, every VLAN has a different range of IPs. Agree? Every VLAN has a different range of IPs. Whenever you create a virtual machine, you want the machine should pick automatically one IP. For that, you need DHCP server. You need DHCP server. The DHCP server might be one or two machines. That's also comes under part of these 50 machines. Like that, if you combine all of them, you will see some example, you will see some 50 machines are running. Now, what about your vCenter appliance? Your vCenter appliance, does customer bother about your vCenter appliance? Or it's just internal management server? Vivek, come on, quickly.
Management purpose.
Internal purpose only, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, every day morning, you came to office and you log into vCenter and you perform the health check. What is your day-to-day task? When you enter into the office, you log in, check your emails, then log into VMware vCenter and see if there are any errors, any VM is down, any VM is 100% CPU utilized, or any host is down, or any host is having some memory or CPU issues, or any data stores are getting full, or anyone randomly created some non-standard machines or something. You will perform all these health checks in the morning. Okay, that is your day-to-day task, for example. So you're trying to log in into vCenter, that vCenter itself is down. What you will do? vCenter is a virtual machine running on this cluster only. Cluster only. Yesterday when you saw, it is running on host one. Now the vCenter is down. What you will do? Only vCenter is down. Rest of the servers are running. Customer machines also running, and your internal management servers also running. No issues. You haven't seen any issues. Only vCenter is down due to some issue. What you will do? If a vCenter is there, then only you can log in and check all the host and all the machines. If a vCenter itself is down, what you will do? First, you'll have to bring your vCenter up and running.
Okay. With the help of ILO, we can do that.
Sorry?
With the help of ILO?
ILO? Excuse me, boss. I'm saying,
can check what the...
Excuse me, boss. I'm saying your vCenter appliance is virtual machine. Virtual machine doesn't have an ILO.
Yeah, right.
Understand the scenario. Virtual machine is down, not the host. Only one VM. That maybe the host is having 100 VMs. Doesn't matter. Only this particular VM is down due to some memory leakage or some kernel crash or something. Something happened. Now you need to identify that. Getting my point? So if a vCenter itself is down, what you will do? You will have to log in into each host manually. Can we log in into each and every host manually?
No.
Why can't you log in? Root and password. You have a ESXi
code. Yes, we can log in.
Then what's wrong in it? I'm not saying host is down. Host is up and running. Host is functioning normal. Virtual machine is down. Okay. I am saying yesterday I'm working on the vCenter. I found that my vCenter appliance is running on host one. Okay. Today morning you came to office and you tried to log in. vCenter is not working. Now what you will do? You will log into host one or not?
Yes. We can log in host one first.
Possible
yes.
Or not? Okay. Now you logged into the view host one. Now you logged into the host one. vCenter appliance is not there. It is not there in the host one because the vCenter appliance is running on host one yesterday. Maybe after some time, okay, DRS might be executed and it is vMotion onto some other host. in which host it is running. There is no way to find out. Is there any way?
No.
Okay. Now, your only option is log in into each and every host and check if the machine is there or not. If the machine is there or not. Any other options you think of? Quickly, come on.
No.
Okay, you have to log into each and every host, identify whether my vCenter is there or not. vCenter is there or not. Okay, somehow you found the vCenter on 25th ESXi because that has been vMotioned from host 1 to host 24 yesterday due to some calculation what it has done in the backend. When the DRS is executed every 5 minutes, it is decided that vCenter is the one which is utilizing more. Let's move the vCenter from host 1 to host 25. That has been done. And after that, maybe in the midnight, the host is the vCenter appliance is down. Okay, now you have, if you want to troubleshoot, you need to log in into each and every host.
Can we trace through the IP address of vCenter?
If the vCenter is down, ping is not working. How trace route will work?
Trace route. So we can get where it is going. Like what is the and
if the mobile phone is on, then you can dial and you will see the phone is ringing or not. If the phone is switched off, what you will do? Same thing with the trace route. Trace route will give you the path. It will not give you whether the VM is running on host 1 or it will not give you whether the VM is running on host 100. Okay. Trace route will
so
give you.
So we cannot check the.
There is no other alternate way. There is no other alternate way. You have to log in into each host and check for machine whether the required machine is there or not. That is only the option.
Okay.
Inside the virtual machine, you cannot really identify. Okay, this virtual machine is running on host 10, host 20, host 100. No. There is no way to find out whether the VM is running on host 1 or host 2. Okay. If you log into the virtual machine, you can only see the virtual machine. You never know what is there in the background. Okay. Now, this is one of the virtual machine. I'll give you access. Can you tell me on which host it is running? You getting my point? This is one of the Windows VM.
Yes.
Okay, now can you tell me on which host it is running? Right? There is no way. So, same problem with, I'm just giving one problem statement. The vCenter is down. These are the difficulties that you will face. Similarly, you have such VMs. Every time when you want to do something, okay, you have to spend a lot of time in it. So what you can do, out of 64, you select three host and create one group called management host group and select all the VMs. All the VMs in the sense, don't select 950, select all these 50. Okay, select all these 50 VMs and create one more group saying management VMs. These are management VMs. Now apply the rule saying all these management VMs must run on management host only. Means in any condition, these 50 VMs must be running on these three hosts only. So if the DRS want to run, okay, it can run. This machine, it can move here, and this machine, it can move here. That's it. Or this machine, it can bring here, it can bring here. All these 50 VMs will revolve in the smaller boundary called three host. So that it is easy for me, if something goes wrong, I can easily log into these three hosts, identify what's going on. You're getting my point?
Yes.
Okay. That doesn't mean that doesn't mean can't we run these 950 VMs over here? Yes, you can run customer VMs also on this host. That's okay. But DRS will not touch management VMs to go out of the circle. Okay, that rule you call it as host VM to host mapping. VM to host mapping. How to create that? Let's see. You getting what I'm saying? So go to cluster, go to cluster, identify some VMs. Now, virtual machine 7, virtual machine 7, and virtual machine 4. Sorry, virtual machine 7, virtual machine 8, and virtual machine 6, 7, 8. These three are the management VMs. They must stay on host 1. They must stay on host 1, or they must stay on host 2. Let's see. Host 2 is overutilized. Already 4 VMs are running. I am saying they must run on host 2, means this is my management host, and 7, 8, and 6 are management VMs. 6, 7, 8 are management VMs. So what should happen? After execute the rule, 6 and 7, they will be motioned on to host 2. Now already host 2 has 4 VMs. Okay, and you are trying to migrate 2 more VMs onto host 2. Then it will become 6 VMs. Out of 9, 6 is running on one host, again overutilized. So what it will do, some of the other VMs, 5 or 9, it will migrate to other place, and it will bring 6 and 7 back to here. You understand? Just to load balance. It should follow all the rules. Also, it should do the load balancing. You getting my point?
Yes.
Okay, go to configure, host and VM groups, create. MGMT underscore VM group 1, VM group, add 6, 8, 7. Okay, so these are the three VMs for VM group. Another host underscore, sorry, MGMT underscore host group 1, host group, add 2. Normally you'll have a 64 host, you will select 3 in your real time. That's it. Done. Two groups has been created. Now go to virtual machine rules, create management VMs underscore role 1. Okay, management VMs role 1, host to virtual machine. All the management VMs must run on management host. Okay, that's it. Done. Now you go to monitor 6, 6, 7, 8. These three must be running on host 2. Okay, and DRS, run DRS. Now just watch it. After some time, few VMs will be migrated. First of all, 6 and 7, they migrated back onto. Now VM1 and VM9, they are going away, because 6 and 7 they came back to host 2, but host 2 is already overloaded, so it is moving 2 VMs out and bringing 2 VMs in. Now let's go back and see. 6, 7, 8 on the same host, as per your first rule, as per your this rule. Okay, let's check all the rules. Configure rules. What is the first rule? VM 2 and 3. 2 and 3, they must be in a separate. Check. 3. 2 is running here, 3 is running here. Satisfied? What is the second rule? Second rule is 1 and 9, they must be on same host. Host VMs 1 and 9. 1 and 9, they must be on same host. Satisfied? And what is the other rule? 6, 6, 7, 8, they must be running on host 2. Go to VMs 6, 7, 8, running on host 2. Satisfied? All the rules? Any confusion? Okay. While load balancing, system is also following the rules what we have set. If you have 1,000 machines or 1,500 machines in your customer environment, and you have a 64 host, and you have around 20 or 25 rules in the vCenter, imagine how difficult it is to manage. Even if you want to modify something, you will think 1 or 2 hours. What to do? What will happen? What should I do? You getting my point? Okay, Vivek?
Yes.
Understood? Any confusion, any questions? No, yes.
No.
Fine. Let me stop here. We still have a couple of things to discuss here. Okay, related to HA and DRS, that we will do it tomorrow. Let me stop here.